In this video, I'm going to attempt to replace the hard drive in this 2009 iMac. If I'm successful, you'll probably see this video, and if I'm not, this will probably never make it to the internet. I have instructions up on iFixit.com's website. I'll be following those to change out this hard drive. To get started, I'll need to remove the glass panel from the front. You need some specialized suction cups to do that, or I'm using a suction cup soap tray, because that's all I have. I press that down in the corner and lift up. That was very easy. Now you don't want to get the backside of this glass dirty, so I'll go find a safe place for this. Next, I'm going to use a T10 Torx screwdriver to remove the screws from around the perimeter. Next, I'm going to lift the panel. And I'm going to pull the vertical sync cable out of its socket. Next, I'll be disconnecting the LED power cable. You press down on this lever and then pull it out. Now I'll be detaching the display data cable. Next is the thermal sensor cable. Now we can lift the panel out of the case. I'm going to check for any cables you might have missed. Now that we have the panel removed, we want to focus on removing the hard drive. We want to remove the thermal sensor, and then we want to remove the data and the power cables on the hard drive. Next, we want to remove these two T10 Torx screws. Then the hard drive should pivot out. And we have the hard drive removed. Before I put a new hard drive in this, I'm going to take this outside and blow some of the dust out of the system while I have it open. Okay, I've returned from blowing the dust out of the system. My preferred method for cleaning the dust out of a computer is to take it outside and use an electric leaf blower at a distance to just kind of blow any loose dust. I don't like to use air compressors or clean the computer up close because you're likely to lodge dust into places where it shouldn't be. But next, I'll prepare the hard drive for installing into the iMac. I'm going to be installing the Samsung 840 Evo. As you know, this is a 2.5-inch drive, and the original drive is a 3.5-inch drive. I'm going to be using a drive converter that came with this OCZ Vertex 4 solid-state drive that I have, that I haven't used. You can buy these adapters online, too. I just happen to have this one. I had to pause the video for a second to find some mounting screws. I've also come to the realization that this bracket isn't quite going to work, but I may try and adapt it to work. We'll see. I'll start by mounting the hard drive to the bracket. So we want the hard drive connector to be in the same orientation. So there's a bracket on this side of the hard drive. The other side has pins in it. This does not look like it's going to work. I'll have to come up with some other sort of solution. Okay, so what I've done is I've removed the rubber grommet here. And then I've drilled a hole so I can mount on these two screws. I don't really need any sound isolation or vibration isolation on this, since it's a solid-state drive. It's not going to move or make any noise. So that's half of it. I'm going to try and figure out the other half, and then we'll continue. Okay, so I've come up with a satisfactory mount for this drive. If you're doing this, it's probably best to order a mount ahead of time that will work with the system. So I drilled the hole here and mounted this on the side with the bracket. The other side, there were two pins in the drive before. What I've done is I've just screwed a screw in this bracket so it'll fit in the mount here, and then I can screw it into the case. So it's not going to be supported by this one side, but I will say this is a lot lighter than the hard drive, so I'm not really worried about the weight wearing on the mounts or anything, and it doesn't move, so I'm not worried about the sound isolation so much either. So now I'll screw the hard drive mount into this iMac. That's satisfactory to me. It doesn't seem like it's going to fall out. Next, and I did check these cables will stretch enough. We'll plug in the power and data cables here. Now, the solid-state hard drive does not have a thermal connector on it. I've done research online. There are a number of different ways. Some people modify this cable to work with the new hard drive. I'm going to try and use a software-based fan control. So if what I've read is correct, when we start this up, the fan will run at full speed until we get that control software installed. But I'll just leave this. Actually, I'm going to get a small zip tie and zip tie that up. Okay, so now reassembly will be the opposite of disassembly. Okay, in reassembly, the first step is to replace the panel. You want to try not to touch this because we'll clean it. But the less clean you have to do, the better. So next, we're going to reconnect the LCD thermal sensor cable. This is pretty tight in here. After that is the display data cable. Looks like I have it fully seated. That was actually kind of tricky to put in. I've propped up the LCD with some plastic containers here. Next, we'll connect the LED backlight cable. And finally, we'll have the vertical sync cable here. This doesn't have a clip, it just slides in. Okay, I'm going to take out my prop here. I'm going to double check one last time and make sure I don't have any cables I've missed. Looks good. We'll lower the cable in place and make sure I have all the holes lined up. Looks like I do. Now it's time to put in the perimeter screws. So the panel's back in. Next thing I'm going to do is boot this up before I put the glass on, because if it doesn't boot, there's no point in putting the glass on. That's a good sign. Okay, so I've booted into the recovery console. I feel confident that the machine is working for the most part, so I'm going to replace the glass. I'm going to just power this down. Okay, before you replace the glass, you want to clean this glass. The outside of this and the inside of the piece you're going to put on here, I'm just going to use a microfiber cloth. You don't want any dust trapped between the two layers. This is a very glossy surface, so it's very easy to see if you have any dust left on here. I'm going to hinge this on the bottom of the screen. And then pop it back into place. And that's the hard drive replacement on the iMac. Okay, so I've gone through the process of reinstalling the system and then recovering data with a Time Machine backup. So I have my system back to normal. There are a couple different things. I had to install a system update and there are some things like that I had to do, but it wasn't too bad. And now the fan is running at full speed, so I'm going to use this SSD fan control software. It's from an unidentified developer, so we'll have to go into System Preferences and then Security and then click Open Anyway. We'll install this on the main hard drive. Then we'll restart. Okay, so I'm going to open up the utility here, the SSD fan control utility, and I see it's running at 5600 RPMs. Looks like there's a couple modes here. Here's a manual mode. Then there's a smart mode that will actually utilize the smart technology on the solid-state hard drive to determine what temperature to use. So I'm going to use the smart mode here. That seems like the best option. So this has dropped the speed down to, I was dropping about 1100 RPM. I don't know if that's going to drop more, maybe. Okay. So the next thing I want to talk about in this video is also the speed of this drive. So I'm going to open up Blackmagic Speed Test. And I'll just run a quick test here. This machine uses serial ATA 2.0. Modern machines would use 3.0. I've run this drive in a newer machine, and you might get 400 or 500 megabytes per second In this machine, we're getting about 220 write speed and about 270 read speed. The drive that was in it, if I remember correctly, I think was about 40 megabyte write and read speed or something like that. I can't quite remember. But so it is quite a bit faster, but it's not as fast as a newer machine with the Serial ATA 3.0 on it. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.